What's up, internet? I am Manish from RebellionRider.com and welcome back to my channel where we make learning SQL, PLSQL and Oracle database fun. Before starting today's tutorial, I just want to say thanks to you all as this YouTube channel has crossed 5 million views and 30,000 subscribers. Thank you so much guys, without you this would not have been possible. So without wasting much of your precious time, let's start our PLSQL tutorial. Today we will learn how to create nested tables using user-defined data type. Just for the reminder, we have already seen the creation of nested table using PLSQL primitive data types in the last tutorial. You can check it out, link is in the description. So let's do the example. First, we will create a user-defined data type and then use it for creating the nested table. Here, I have created a user-defined data type which is an Oracle object. Objects require no introduction if you have ever studied OOP concept. Anyways, let's come to the topic. Here in Oracle, like other programming languages, object type is a kind of a data type which works in the same way as other data types such as char, varchar2, number or others, but with more flexibility. Here for this demonstration, I have created an Oracle object with name object underscore type. To create this object, we used createType statement which starts with the keyword create followed by the keyword type. In between these two keywords, you can use an optional clause or replace, which if it finds any will change the definition of the Oracle object which has the same name as the one you are creating. If it does not find one, then it will create a fresh object for you followed by the name of the object. Is a reserved phrase as object, which indicates to the compiler that you want to create a top level object type. Then we have a parenthesis inside which we define objects' attributes, methods or other properties. In our case, the object object underscore type has two attributes, obj underscore id and obj underscore name. The first attribute is of number type while the other one is of varchar2 type. Let's compile and create this object. Object created successfully. Now using this user defined data type, we will create the nested table. The process of creating a nested table is same as the one we saw in the last tutorial, except this time the element type will be the user defined data type. Let's create the nested table type.
Got yourself something funky.
As you can see, this create type statement using which we created the nested table my underscore nt is same as the one we did in the last tutorial, except that this time instead of primitive data type we used user defined data type which is Oracle object that we created above. Let's also compile this statement and create this nested table. Nested table created. Our nested table is based on user defined data type which is an Oracle object. This object has two attributes, obj underscore id and obj underscore name. These two objects will become the columns of the nested table my underscore nt. Now you can put your nested table to work. For example, you can use it for defining a column of another table. So let's see how. Here I have a demo table with the name base underscore table which has two columns, tab underscore id and tab element, which is tab underscore ele. The first column is of number data type, whereas the second column is of my underscore nt type, which is our nested table. That means the column tab underscore ele consists of a table my underscore nt into it. As we discussed in the last tutorial, that whenever we define a column of a table as nested table type, then we have to define a storage table for it as well as inform the compiler about it. We do that using store as and nested table clause, as we did here. After the closing parenthesis of create table DDL, we specify the clause nested table followed by the name of the column which we defined as nested table type. Followed by that, we have store as clause, using which we specify the name of a storage table for a nested table type column. This name could be any user defined name that fulfills the norms for create table DDL naming standards, which in our case is store underscore tab underscore one. Let's compile. Table created successfully. Note that all the above tables which we created have no constraints, index or anything created on them. Those are purely for explaining the concept. Please head over to my blog on the same topic and learn how to insert, update and retrieve data from the above created tables. Link is in the description. That's it for today. Make sure to give this video a big thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, as many such tutorials are yet to come. You can also help others in learning and also help me and my channel in growing by sharing this video with your friends on your social media. That's all about the PLSQL tutorial on how to create nested table using user defined data type in Oracle database. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.